Hello and welcome to this presentation. My name is Kevin Kerr and I'm the Regional Council Manager for Birth to Five Illinois, Region 56, covering Will County. In this webinar, the Region 56 team will present our Early Childhood Regional Needs Assessment Report findings, which will include the regional strengths, needs, and recommendations. Following this presentation, we ask that you complete the feedback form so we can continue to include your authentic input in early learning decision-making. We also ask that you share with at least one person the needs assessment so that we can work collectively as a region to fulfill the recommendations presented. A link to the full report and the feedback form can be found in the description below. If you would like to turn on closed captioning, click the CC icon at the bottom of the video. This will turn on the captions. If you want a language different than English, click on the gear icon for settings, click on subtitles, then auto translate, and you can scroll down to pick the language you want. In 2021, the Illinois Commission on Equitable Early Childhood Education and Care Funding issued a report with findings that highlighted the inequities in early childhood funding in Illinois and the need to create a better statewide infrastructure to support early childhood professionals, expand services and programs for families and caregivers, and increase enrollment in early learning programs. The report focused on the importance of addressing racial inequities and the need to include local feedback in the conversations that funders and decision makers were having about early childhood education and care. Birth to Five Illinois is working in every town, village, and city throughout Illinois to find out why families are not able to access early childhood services. We are working with state and local decision makers to inform them of what the Will County community has to say about accessing early childhood services. Each region across the state has a team of three who work together on connecting with the community to carrying out the Birth to Five Illinois mission. Joining me in the Region 56 office are Madeline Snowden, our Family and Community Engagement Specialist, and our Administrative Support Specialist, Erica Labergio.
Our mission is to find out why families are not able to access early childhood services. We're working with state and local decision makers to inform them of what the Will County community has to say about accessing early childhood services. We're moving the community forward so we can access early learning in an equitable and inclusive way. Our work is directly helping decision makers use authentic community feedback to decide what is best for Will County. Doing this will create more equitable early childhood education and care opportunities in Will County that respects family and community input. Birth to Five Illinois has three main values and goals. First, we must prioritize family feedback and input. Second, we must address racial inequities that exist in our early childhood system. And third, we will use the collective impact model to shift the current early childhood system to influence policy and funding at the local, regional, and state level. Two critical parts of the new statewide infrastructure are family councils and action councils. Located in each of the 39 regions, the councils provide feedback on quantitative data from the Illinois Early Childhood Asset Map, or ICAM, and the Illinois Network of Child Care Referral Agencies, or INCRA, to help contextualize the data at the local level. The councils meet twice a month in virtual, in-person, or hybrid meetings. The family councils are comprised of parents and caregivers from a wide variety of family types, like single parents, adoptive and foster parents, caregivers of relatives, teen parents, two-family households, two-parent households, multi-generational families, and more, and prioritize the voices of those who have not been involved in this type of work before. We want to highlight those who have been involved in our Region 56 Family Council over the past year and thank them endlessly for sharing their experiences with the early childhood system. Jessica Barclay, Krista Escamillo, Takara Jolowit, Latoya Johnson, Laura Kimmel, Erica Ortiz Wassenaar, Juanita Quezada, Heather Ramirez, Norma Romo, Victoria Theodosopoulos, and Raquel Young. Action councils are comprised of early childhood education and care professionals, healthcare providers, faith leaders, elected officials, and other community members. Action Council members were invited to bring additional information on local programs and services provided by their agencies or organizations to complement the existing data from ICAM and INCRA. We extend thanks and gratitude to our Region 56 Action Council members, Elise Boyd Johnson, Stephanie Budzinski, Deborah Clark, Sherry Coe, Kathy Fudge White, Elizabeth Kaufman, Paula Kennedy, Amy Loy, Amy Martin, Hassan Von Schlegel, Sandover Thomas, Stephanie Thompson, and Sherita Townsend Bowens. Beyond the council meetings, additional qualitative data was collected community-wide through focus groups and interviews, and all council members were invited to provide input on each section of their early childhood regional needs assessment. As a community, we developed recommendations for our region with family and community feedback at its core. The following slides highlight some data that was discussed by council members and provide insights into early childhood education and care landscape in our region.
Region 56 is home to a diverse and fast-growing population. Region 56 is home to over 43,000 kids under the age of six, most of which are Caucasian, followed by Latine. 27% of children under the age of six live at or below 200% of the federal poverty level. The federal poverty level is a measure of income used to determine eligibility for certain programs and benefits, including enrollment into state and federally funded early learning programs. This means a family size of two is making approximately $39,000 annually. The region is also home to many priority populations, including children and families with refugee or asylum status, children experiencing homelessness, children of teen parents, and children and families living in poverty and deep poverty. Region 56 Local Early Childhood Collaboration, All Our Kids Early Childhood Network, started in 2004. The AOK network hosts monthly meetings with local early childhood and community professionals. The AOK network in Will County has had many successes, one of which included piloting and launching the Integrated Referral and Intake System, otherwise known as IRIS, in February of 2020. IRIS is a web-based information and referral system that engages early childhood providers and family support services to provide a clear referral path for families. The region is home to many early childhood education and care programs. This map indicates publicly funded early childhood locations. As you can see, the majority of these programs, including other childcare options not pictured, are in the northern half of the region, resulting in more than 15 known childcare deserts. It's important to note also that besides the programming options mentioned and detailed in the map, that families have the option to choose what's best for their kids. This includes utilizing family, friends, and neighbor care. Regardless of the childcare options, families often state that programming hours don't align with a true full day of work and or school, forcing many families to pick between working and childcare. Early childhood education and care workforce is the entry point and backbone to increasing childcare slots and reducing childcare deserts in our region and across the state. We spoke to many teachers and childcare providers, and there were many themes highlighted throughout these conversations. The childcare workforce is largely underpaid, many not having access to health or retirement benefits, and professional development opportunities or access to continuing education is lacking. Directors and owners of ECEC locations stated that these challenges have made it extremely hard to recruit, hire, and retain qualified staff. Without a dedicated and passionate workforce, access to programming will continue to be challenging for families across our region and across the state. Families in the region have stated that they are confused and often overwhelmed when they need to search for childcare or other childcare services. There is not one all-encompassing source of information for understanding how to navigate early learning. A Will County mom reported that, and I quote, "As a new mother in Joliet, I started looking for childcare. I had no clue where to start. I eventually found a center, but the wait list was very long and I could not enroll my child for several months," end quote. The Will County Birth to Five Illinois team has spent the last year deeply involved in the area to fully understand the early childhood education and care landscape. Based on direct feedback from our councils, focus groups, and through countless interviews, the following are some of the key strengths and needs. Identified strengths include regional public transportation infrastructure, passionate ECEC providers and provider network, an abundance of school districts, access to culturally diverse family engagement opportunities, dedicated informal community partnerships and an official collaboration, the AOK, regional commitment from families to strengthen services for children and the most underserved, and robust family engagement opportunities, for example, public libraries, park districts, parks, etc. The following, as identified through our focus groups, interviews, and councils, are areas of growth. English as a second language, programs and services for children and families, full-day ECEC programming that supports working hours and non-traditional employment work schedules, streamlined and understandable ECEC systems for families and providers to navigate, the reduction and/or elimination of childcare deserts, increased investments in transportation around ECEC needs specifically, quicker child care assistance program turnaround times for approval and payments, and intentional training and support opportunities for ECEC professionals and providers who care for children with special needs. Based on community and council conversations, Recommendations have been made on how early childhood education and care programs and services can be improved for families in the region. Recommendations will then be presented to lawmakers, state agencies, local elected officials, and funders so they can better understand the needs of families in the region and share the recommendations with them so they can see how to best meet those needs. These are a few of the recommendations made, but more can be found in our regional needs assessment. Recommendation number one, state regional community model of partnership. Recommendation number two, create one state ECEC agency with unified ECEC data systems. Recommendation number three, full day ECEC programming. Recommendation number four, ECEC workforce investments. And recommendation number five, elimination of childcare deserts.
This summer, we will be out in the community, talking to more families, providers, and stakeholders about their experiences with early childhood education and care. And we want to talk with you. We invite community members, families, and early childhood professionals to join the conversation by filling out a council interest form. Please go to www.birth25il.com/councils or click the link in the description to get involved. Interest forms will close later this summer with council meetings fully resuming in August. Proud to be a department of INCRA, Illinois Network of Childcare Resource and Referral Agencies. Grateful for funding from the Illinois State Board of Education and the Illinois Department of Human Services. We encourage you to stay in touch with us by visiting our regional page at www.birth25il.com/region56 or use any other contact options in the description below. Please complete the feedback form linked in the description below so we can continue to include your authentic input in Will County early learning decision making. Thank you for your time and for sharing your valuable feedback.